Hello guys, welcome to our YouTube channel. If this is your first time here, I'm Leanne
and this is Baby Belle.
On this channel, we talk all things mum and baby, toddler, and today we're going to be talking about money. So we all know that January is like the longest month ever. Christmas can be really expensive. December's payday is like a week or two early. So that then means that January feels like it's about 4 months long just on its own. And January is the time when we all seem to start thinking about sorting out our lives, usually starting with our diets and our finances. My diet is definitely something that I need to be working on, but I have got my finances under control, so I thought I would share some of my favourite and best tips with you for making it through January, saving some money, and carrying on into the rest of the year. Okay, so the first thing is budget. You have to budget your money. If you know what you've got coming in and you know what you've got going out, then you're in control of it already. So I have done like a basic budgeting video and I'll link that down in the description. And also I'll leave a link as well to a couple of budgeting spreadsheets for you to go and have a look at if that's something that you need to get. But that is the most important thing. If you know where your money is going, then you can have a look to see where you can make changes. Thank you. Compare utility provider prices. And a lot of us just assume that we're on the best deal already when actually we're not, and families can save up to £200 a year by switching. I'll leave a link in the description to Ofgem's approved energy comparison sites. The next thing is review all of your direct debits. Are there ones on there that you've completely forgotten about? Have you got an unused gym membership that you need to cancel off? Is there mobile phone insurance from like a phone you had 5 years ago? Direct debits generally only finish when you cancel them unless they're set up with an end date. So if you've just got one set up to go indefinitely, it will carry on going even if you don't need it. And it's so easy to just ignore that £10 or £15 that's coming out every month. If you did put all or a lot of your Christmas spending onto a credit card, have a look at 0% balance transfers. So that basically means if you've put a certain amount onto your credit card, you transfer it over to a new provider and you have 0% interest for, it's normally like a year. It can add up to quite a bit. Hello, where are you going? This one could be a little bit controversial, but sell any unwanted or unsuitable Christmas presents. So you've probably got a lot of stuff for Christmas, and people have the best intentions in the world, but sometimes you look at a present and you just think, wow, thank you. So sell them or re-gift them. If you've got a birthday coming up in the next couple of weeks, you might have something that's suitable, and that could save hundreds of pounds depending on what you've got and what birthdays you've got coming up. If anyone who gave us presents is watching this, don't worry, I'm not re-gifting any of them. If you do need to buy things in January, have a look at loyalty cards. So a lot of companies do loyalty cards. You've got Nectar Points for Sainsbury's, you've got Boots Vantage card, you've got Tesco Club card, and those points all add up. Now we save ours up over the year and then use them to buy Christmas food and drinks. So although we were away this Christmas, we got all of the Boxing Day food and that with our Nectar Points, so it was like free food for us. So loyalty cards are one thing, and also as well, cashback sites. So I've talked about cashback sites quite a few times. I talked about it in our Making Extra Money on Maternity Leave video. I also talked about it in our Christmas money saving tips video. Cashback sites are amazing. So I use Quidco. I'll leave a link down in the description for you. Basically anyone that they're partnered with, you get cashback on things that you buy. So that could be, it could be 1%, it could be 10%. They are really, really good. And then have a look for discount codes online and on Instagram. There's so many different discount codes that you can use, and a lot of them help other people. So if someone's got a discount code and you use it, they might get a bit of commission, or they might get 10% off of their next purchase. So find a discount code, and if you've got like 20% off of something that you do need to buy, that's a winner. My next tip is buy own branded products instead of branded products. Now, I know that doesn't work for everything. For example, I wouldn't be able to eat unbranded cornflakes or supermarket owned Coca-Cola, but there are a lot of things that you can buy that you can't tell the difference with. So for example, like medicines and stuff, rather than buying Nurofen, we'll just buy ibuprofen, and there's loads of things, and it just does work out so much cheaper. And also switching supermarkets as well. Some supermarkets are a lot more expensive than others, and I know that a lot of people say that they've switched from like Sainsbury's to Aldi, and it just saves them loads of money. down on takeaway coffees. If you can, give them up for the whole of January and just make them, like, just a standard flat white can be like £3 or something. If you're buying two of those a day, that's £6 a day. And if you were to do that every day January, that's over £180 that you could save. And also on that theme, make your own lunch rather than buying it. Now, I know it's just so much easier to just nip out and grab something from Subway or a sandwich from your local Tesco or whatever, but if you make your own lunch, then you're going to be saving quite a bit of money. Add that to your coffee that you're saving money on, and that is quite a bit of savings. Meal plan, bulk buy, meal prep, and batch cook. If you spend a couple of hours on a Sunday planning your meals, buying your food, cooking it all up and putting it away, then you're not going to be tempted to buy takeaways. We do that. And do you know what, it makes a huge amount of difference. On the weeks when we haven't planned and prepped everything, we do end up getting to like Wednesday or Thursday and it's just like, oh, let's just order something off of Just Eat. So planning it all out and just having written down what you're going to eat that week and having it all prepped just makes a huge amount of difference. It also saves money as well, because if you bulk buy, it's cheaper and it might stop you from just nipping into like your Sainsbury's local, which tend to be more expensive, and buying bits and pieces as you go. Dry January, I've got that one on the list. So something that I do every year, and this year I failed it already because I actually had a glass of white wine spritzer on New Year's Day. If you do drink regularly or you do drink occasionally or whatever, dry January is a good way to save money because we know that alcohol isn't particularly cheap. And then with all that time that you're saving not going out, you could try growing your own food. I've done this once, grew some carrots and something else, I can't remember. Oh, these are all coming out. Grew some carrots. Baby girl, that's too noisy. I grew some carrots, they weren't brilliant, but that is something that we are planning on doing once we've got a suitable garden. You could also sell stuff, so not just your unwanted Christmas presents, but anything. Like having a good clear out of stuff in January is great, and then if you've got anything that's suitable, selling it. Facebook Marketplace, Vinted, Baby Bell. Facebook Marketplace, Vinted, car boot sales, all of that. If you've got stuff, sell it. You'd be surprised at how much money you can make. I do apologise for the very noisy child in the background. Start a side hustle. There are so many different things that you could do to make a little bit of extra money. Having a look into side hustles. I know there's like hundreds and thousands of videos on YouTube that will give you some really good ideas. And then my last one on that one, obviously you've got all this extra time because you're not going out drinking, walk or cycle if you can. I beg your pardon. Walk or cycle if you can. So obviously January, the weather's not great, but if you can cut down on the amount that you use your car or the amount that you use public transport, not only do you get out in the fresh air, get a little bit of exercise, feel a bit better, you're also saving a bit of money. So those are all the tips I've got for this video. Let me know in the comments if you've got any other ones. Obviously that's going to help me, it's going to help anyone else that's reading the comments. So do let us know if there's anything obvious that I've missed or anything that you find really effective. As usual, we really hope that you enjoyed this video and found it useful. If you did, don't forget to leave us a like and a comment and hit that subscribe button. It makes us really happy and it lets YouTube know that the video is worth showing to other people. We'll see you next time. Say bye. Say bye. No?